light that changed my life. The greatest discovery of my generation is that human beings can alter their lives by altering their attitudes of mind, said by William James. In 1980s, I graduated from law school. Thought I had be a lawyer for the rest of my life. After all, that's what I wanted to do since my early teenage years. At the first, everything went about according to plan. After lots of studying that summer, I passed the bar examination and was admitted to practice law in New York. My personal life was also on upswing in early 1981. I married Dolores, a law school classmate. I was on my way to much success and happiness, or so I thought. But after practicing law for a few years, I realized I wasn't happy at all. So there were some things I liked about being a lawyer. I enjoyed helping people resolve their disputes, especially when I could save them to agony of lengthy court processing. But there were so many things about being an attorney that I disliked, and that just seems to be drain the life out of me. Mounds and mounds of tedious paperwork and motion to be filled. Constant delay and postpones. It was not uncommon for a trial to be postponed 10 times. I dreaded going to work. I continued to grind out the work, but grew more and more dissatisfied as an attorney. I was frustrated and very depressed, to put it bluntly. I didn't like my life, and I saw no way that things were going to improve. Have you ever had a job where you dreaded going to work most days, where you felt the weight of the world on your shoulder each day? Well, that's how I felt. I was literally hunched over and in pain, both physically and emotionally. I looked much older than my years. I began to get headaches all the time, and my stomach was constantly churning. Fearing that I had some serious health problem, I saw some doctor and they ordered a battery of tests. Every test came back with the same result. They couldn't find anything physically wrong with me. One of the doctors suggested that I take Malax to calm my upset stomach. Spiritually, I was dead. Nothing in my life had much meaning. This day-to-day drudgery was also affecting my appearances. Although I was in my late 20s, I looked like I was 40. In the early part of 1985, shortly after I had turned 30 years old, I was burned out. And one particular evening while sitting alone in my den, I knew that something had to change. Not knowing what to do, I simply said out loud, "There's got to be more to my life than this. There's got to be more than this misery and unhappiness." Help comes from an unlikely source. Later that night, I was watching TV in the den. It was around 1 a.m. and my wife, Dolores, had already gone to bed, but I was feeling so down, I couldn't sleep. I channel surfed looking for something to occupy my time. I turned into all of my things and information. Normally, I wouldn't have changed that. Channel is a fraction of a second, but for some reason, I listened. The product being pedal was called the Mental Bank, was endorsed by actress Florence Henderson and Daddy Bunch fame. The Mental Bank was a home study course that explained how everything we achieve in a life is based upon our subconscious beliefs. I felt so desperate at that point that I decided to go for it. I pulled out my credit card and ordered the program. That night in my den was the turning point of life. But the way when I slipshodly told Dolores what I had done a day or 2 days later, she was shocked. "You did what?" she asked in amazement. It's not that she objected to the purchase. It was just so out of the character for me to buy something like that and infuse and brush it from a TV infomercial. Several days later, the Mental Bank program arrived at my doorstep, and I was fascinated and excited to begin learning how to thoughts determine the quality of your lives. Prior to that time, I had never heard this idea. Unfortunately, they don't teach you this stuff in school. The Mental Bank program spurred me to seek out other motivational resources. I began to read books by Napoleon Hill, O.G. Mandino, Norman Vincent Peale, and Robert Scholars. I started reading the Bible and regular basic, and I eagerly listened to inspiring audio cassette program by Earl Nightingale and many others. I felt like a person who had wandered for days in the desert with a parched throat and then suddenly found a stream of water. Now I can't tell you that everything in my life changed overnight, because it didn't happen that way. But from the moment I began to change from negative attitude to a positive attitude, I started to get significant results. I felt better, I had more energy, and I started to achieve goals that I would never have accomplished before, all because of change in my attitude. I'm also happy to report that when people now ask how old I am and I say 45, then invariably reply, "You look so much younger." It's all in the attitude. From a lawyer to motivational speakers, I continue my self-study program in my spare time. While I work full-time as a lawyer, the positive thinking was helping my attitude at work. But I felt a passion for my hobby that I never felt for my work. And I dream about the day I could walk away from my job. In 1989, after 4 years of intensive research about attitude and motivational concept, I agreed to present some adult education seminar in the evening at a local high school. I was to be paid $30 for each 2 hour class. Not the kind of money that's let you quit your day job. As I stood in front of the class to start my first seminar, I was petrified. My heart was pounding and I was sweating. But somehow I managed to muster the courage to just do it. The student loved the class and I got a real adrenaline rush from presenting the material that had revolutionized my own life and that had the power to do same for others. I was on my way. Eventually, the speaking fees grew a little larger, and in 1990, I decided to phase out my law career over the next few years. This wasn't a simple decision. I had gone 4 years of college and 3 years of law school to obtain my law degree. On top of that, I had spent 10 years of my life as a practicing lawyer. When you have that much invested in career, it's not so easy to walk away. Then, of course, there was the money issue. As a lawyer, I was trapped to earn $100,000 in a few years, and I had been earning that much and more for the rest of my professional career. Taking a stand. A positive attitude is a person's passport to better tomorrow.